the coaches equally exchanging pennants and the pins as well. This is a very genuine moment. I comment on it every time. You can't help but not. It just helps remind you of the most important element of competition, and particularly here in the Paralympic Games. It's all about humanity. It's all about the triumph of the human spirit and the ability of these athletes being celebrated under the gaze of the watching eyes around the world. They really are an inspiration in how they conduct themselves both on and off the court, and particularly on the court. It's such a metaphor for life. In the way these athletes, when upended, they are as quick up as any you'll ever see. There really is no standing on ceremony. They just want to compete, and they're up against the best. It's Germany with Miller, one to be looking for, number four. PATZWALD is pretty handy as well, number seven. SCHUNEMANN, 10. She's a threat, but this is the captain's show. Number 14, Marina MOHNEN. She has really been able to dictate terms. And there, their coach, Glinicky, keeps pretty tight rein on things. Just getting himself settled and buckled in for this one. But this is really a reflection of how this tournament is going to shape out. The Canadians, they have a rich history in this sport, in the women's bracket. They do in the men's as well. 92, 96, 2000, they were gold medal Paralympians. As you look at the lineup now, it's OUELLET number seven and MCLACHLAN number five. Those two, equally the youngster, Arinn Young, 20 years of age, number six, can take care of business offensively as well. Bill Johnson has been a part of this program. He's got a family of involvement in this sport. His brother, the assistant coach for the long time men's wheelchair basketball. Great for the Canadian program. And they're the veteran now of seven Paralympic Games, and she the one, as we talk about Tracey Ferguson. Those gold medals back before the turn of the century, then a bronze they take in Athens. It's got a little bit quiet in the last couple games, but Canada are a side that are always going to contend for that medal podium. This is the opening lineup. MOHNEN, number 14, and Miller. They will really set the table for this opening five for the Germans. MCLACHLAN, OUELLET, back to back. And Jamey, Jules, Harnock, and LALONDE, useful as well. But if this is your first look, or even just a reminder, every player has a numerical value, their classification, in accordance with their level of function. The highest level, a 4.5, the lowest level, a 1.0. This is the record for the Germans. Great Britain, they fall by 5 points, but a good scoreline, doubling up and more against the host nation, Brazil. So a total of 14 points allowed on the floor at any one time as a cumulative numerical value for all five players that are on the floor. So a little bit of a juggle, but these coaches have had these lineups and they know exactly what combinations work with which in order to make sure they're playing within the letter of the law. They're always going to utilize their full 14 point allocation. In Canada, with that, to maybe some, maybe to the Brits, a surprise to take them by 7 points in the opener. And then against Argentina, a pretty good day at the office for them. They just really trounced them with the 73-28 scoreline. And you might just be surprised by some of those, but this is the distribution of opportunity in Paralympic sport as well, the worldwide. And it'll be Canada who take the opening tip and into the safe hands of their number 10, Katie Harnock. She's a 33-year-old player for Canada. This women's tie side, a 2.0 classified player. There's a good block, the hand up already. So the average points per game, 17 for MCLACHLAN, 11 in the tournament so far for OUELLET. They're the two leading scorers for the land of the Maple Leaf. Germany with the offload, well taken, in good roll to the basket. And this is a play you'll see often enough from MCLACHLAN. She formerly a rugby player, she likes the long pass. And I bet she tried her hand a little bit at baseball as well, a very popular sport in Canada. And she's got size, strength, and extension. She's got significant power as well. From the outside into Miller. Miller getting handcuffed by a couple Canadian defenders. And this is MCLACHLAN. She was gonna send it. She'll hold on to it. They have 8 seconds in which to get it over the halfway line. They've done that here through LaLonde. And a 24-second shot clock in total. Must hit the rim. Everybody forgetting about LaLonde, and she'll just take the parting of the black seat. And it's through this defense. She tries to travel, but she's lost her balance at the end. MOHNEN, the real strength to counter against the Canadian McLaughlin. She's the captain for this German side. She also with great experience, 37 years of age. She's averaging 19 points a game. And you see the Canadians with these temporary tattoos that they have. LaLonde having them right there across her neck area. Such is the patriotism of the Canadians. They love a good maple leaf as it'll be picked up. The Germans in full stride. ZEYEN will take it. That's just a little too much on it. And McLaughlin, she just surfs her way past the first wave of this German defense. OUELLET gets her pocket picked for a moment. However, Miller doesn't get away with her wallet cleanly. She tries to give her the quick snatch of the ball, and it's not as easy as first intended, as this will bring about a foul, and it will be an inbound. We're just getting underway in this first quarter, so that won't lead to shots as yet. OUELLET has been measured. She'll go off the front of the rim, and it looked as though from the angle that she was going to try to use the glass, but goes off the front, and both teams, as we see, just the one shot from the free throw line is all that has been recorded in this opening 2 minutes, and that's from LaLonde, the Canadian, number 8. That's a pretty sweet-looking number from the outside there, and you hear the snap of the nylon threads as it is up and in 4-2. That's ZEYEN with the 2 points now for Germany. She's a 1.5 classified, a 31-year-old. And this, a response from LaLonde. LaLonde right now with 3 points to her credit. And those some of the other athletes in this competition. The Canadian men, now you had a shot at there, watching and supporting their countrywomen. That, just a great sound effect at how taut the rim is, as there really is no absorption. It has to be precise. OUELLET. So the way that they are allowed to keep positive play or keep going towards the basket, every time, couple times that they touch their wheels, they must bounce it, pass it, or shoot it. Otherwise, that is traveling. Well, that's the difference in this sport. They've left alone the German to come straight in. And if they're going to give her that much room, she's going to exploit it. And this is LINDHOLM. So a couple scorers now for the Europeans. HARNOCK will just deliberate and consider her options. OUELLET comes up a very against Miller, and Miller just thrashing at her with that right hand, distracting to say the least. Well serviced and in on the inbound, the Germans. This is LINDHOLM, who just scored a moment ago. She moves it across to their captain. We haven't seen her really go yet, MOHNEN. She's had one shot at it, but she is just on the outside. And the pass on the inside is followed up with another basket, this for Miller. And Glinicky always looks to be in a constant clench there, in a very strenuous exhale, wanting to make sure he's emphasizing his points with his personnel. There's a feed, and it's right now a little bit disjointed from Canada. They've not been able to really get a rhythm as yet. You've seen in other matches where it, by this point, McLaughlin will have had at least a couple points on the board, but this is a stubborn and relentless German defense, and look at them go. They swat that down, fast break. This will be Miller, who benefits from her original touch of the ball. And they're double teaming McLaughlin right now. They're having a good go at it. As Miller will record this score, that'll take her up to 4 points. She leads this German attack, and that brings about the need for Bill Johnson to call a timeout. And he says, this isn't quite going to plan, ladies. Let's have a little rethink here now. And the last score for Mareike Miller, 26 years of age, another 4.5. So they have MOHNEN and also Miller out there. The two of them combined make up 9 points. So then just 5 to be distributed amongst the remaining 3 players. So the strategy and the tactics obviously shifting depending on the personnel on the floor for your opponents. And Canada have not been able to get going. You're seeing now McLaughlin, number 5, is receiving double coverage. Whenever they think she's going to get the ball, very active defense from Germany, but this one goes up, and the shot from Oulette, it gets her rolling. She's got a couple now, but they are activating very well. They're able to move 3 players and attend to McLaughlin and be effective, and then when she does get the ball, they move one of their 4.5s up against her, and they just are not giving any space or time for her to get into a rhythm. And that has been well worked again to the inside. You're seeing a very fundamentally sound German side who's just executing at a very high level right now. Oulette. She's trying to get it to the inside. It's Lalonde. Lalonde's got a pretty good pair of mitts on her. She takes that in. Safe hands. But she's just a little too robust as she goes up off the glass, and that just kicks out for the defensive rebound. And Germany once again coming forward. This the captain, and she receives a swipe while she takes her shot. It's off the glass and in. And the scoring line now for their captain, MOHNEN, has just been activated. She's looking to go to the line for a 3-point play. And Oulette, it really is impressive just how well they take the ball in one hand. You would suggest that that's maybe a little bit casual, but that's what they need to do. They've got the other hand on their wheelchair trying to get away from traffic. And that's the same size ball as is used in the men's Olympics, NBA, you name it. So there's no discrepancy or no reduction of size in the women's competition. It's just straight up the same game. What used to be with the Wheelchair Basketball International Federation, it used to be a shot. That really is a moment of pure shooting. As into the game, they bring the 3.0 classification. This is Amanda Yan, and she just steps in and takes a shot and gets herself rolling. But there used to be a rule within wheelchair basketball that if you got a shot off and you got it off the backboard, that would reset the shot clock. Not anymore. It's the straight same rules as is in basketball. Must go off the rim to reload up for another 14 seconds. That's if you do get the offensive rebound. So obviously, if the shot is released from your hand before the buzzer sounds, that's the permission for the shot to be allowed. But it's got to hit the rim, and right now they've just had to hit Miller's arms as she's going up. And McLaughlin, a different start for her than in her last match. They played against Argentina, did Canada. And that was a more comfortable outing. Germany just ticking this scoreboard along, and now a half dozen ahead. Monin needs to get her mechanic's license just so she can attend to duties. And I bet you she is. She'll take care of the replacement. Just needs the actual wheel. Here it comes. And it's a pretty simple mechanism just to lock that into place. You see the wheels, the small wheels are bearing her weight right now. And that's just about using and having the bigger wheel on the floor. And obviously much less work with a bigger wheel. That's how you generate speed and cover more court quicker. Miller has been the best shooter in this match so far. She's got 8 points. She's shooting at 75%. And you wouldn't bet against her to continue that efficiency. That is the nature of this German side. Canada have been a little rugged, shall we say, from their shooting positions. It's a little bit hit and miss. And that's why the score line is doubled against them. And again, the space made available to Monin. She doesn't need a second invitation. She will exploit it. And Ouellette, one of the two for Canada, really need to get ignited, and they've not allowed it. It's really been, the flattery should be towards the defense of Germany. They've done a great job of double teaming at the right times, and they've made the right reads. And what I mean by that is they've utilized a lower classified player who they've double teamed up against McLaughlin. And whilst they might not have the height or the same size as she does, they've been able to lock her away from that down low position beside the basket where she's going to be able to use her height and reach to her advantage. She's not getting into those positions. Ouellette with the first of two. Canada need to make the most of everything they are getting. So 3 points total for Ouellette. Lalonde has three. And McLaughlin has yet to score. And Germany are making it a little too easy. Between Miller and Monin, Canada have not found a way in which to align themselves effectively to keep them from having pretty easy looks at the basket. Ouellette, and she just carves her way right through. That was a busy approach from her. It looked a couple times like she was gonna distribute, and then she equally just burrows her way through this German defense and then slots it in. Canada need to take that defensive rebound, cannot afford to be giving additional opportunities for Germany. They don't need him, as they just will cash that second one in. And that's the clinical nature. That's so intimidating, because you know you can ill afford to be inefficient. And Canada right now, with 10 points in the rear of Germany, they're gonna have to improve their shooting percentage and start taking a few risks. Ouellette has the ability to shoot from outside, but when the shots are forced a little bit like that, they aren't the best opportunity in which to get the return of a basket. Houghton on the floor. She was the last player for Canada to score in their matchup against Argentina. They're saying it's not every day that you can get all of your players on the floor and also offensively involved. Now you see the shot clock. Gonna need to work quickly. And they do, look at that. That's a moment for Canada. When they were under pressure, Yan converts it on that long court cross pass. And inside the last minute now, Canada are gonna need to hold this German side. They just are having it mostly their own way. And if they need to create a shot opening, they've been able to generate it without really having to go to plan B or ever really thinking about plan C yet. Plan A has been there for them. Ouellette on her own will drive it outside of the Canadian half and into within now 3-point range. So 2 points from here. thinking about it was Harnock, but they just can't get to McLaughlin, and that really is a credit. There she finally does score. I was going to say, for Monin, who has been able to attach to McLaughlin as required, and you're seeing a much more urgent expression from the Canadian center now. Canada, this is important to be able to prevent. That almost, doesn't it? It goes off the rim. And that was the up and over from just inside of halfway. And Miller's strong enough. That's the, well, one might even describe it as the fireman's carry, just the real lofting effort just to wrap that from about 50-odd feet. But in the closing minute, Canada take a bite out of this German lead and reduce it down to 6. It's quarter time, Germany 20, Canada 14, after the opening 10 minutes of play in the women's wheelchair basketball. This is Group A in the preliminary round. Second quarter action. And these two teams, they're no strangers to another. But it's Germany who are wanting desperately to lead from the front in this one. They have a victory and a loss. And it's number 2, Canada, in this group. Number 3, Germany. And it's the top 4 that we'll go through. But it's about the seeding, who you might play in the other half as the final positioning of the top 4 teams will become apparent after date 5, when everybody will have played their full quota of matches. This in day 4. It's a move to the outside for Jan. Oh my, she really has shown range. She doesn't get as much floor time as other players. She's just over 4 minutes, but she's got 6 points from it. And she's just inside of the line there. They won't credit that as a 3-pointer, but it's always fun in anticipation when you see the 3-point shooters. They generally strong shooters. They have a good fundamental delivery, as does the captain for Germany. It's an 8-point lead as they just continue to apply pressure. They try to tighten the screw on you, do Germany, and hope that the pressure will become telling, because they don't make many mistakes, but now Canada are starting to find a stroke. And Harnock has just found her opening 2 points, so she played the entirety of that opening quarter, and now 2 points to show. That's only her first shot attempt. So she more of a distributor. And they brought on Erin Young, have the Canadians now at number 6, and she'll just take this rebound. So that dynamic hadn't quite been working with Ouellette and McLaughlin. McLaughlin basically being frozen out. And remember, McLaughlin's had a number of injuries over the last several years. In Canada there, again, Jan is starting to carry this load. She was out for 4 months earlier this year, as you see the play coming in. And they need to get a little bit of luck. They got to create their own luck, though, Canada. And Miller, just so dynamic as she just drives through the lane. And that one just goes off of the glass and beyond. It's going to be two shots, but the injuries, as we're talking about, to McLaughlin, who's been taken out. 4 months illness already in 2016. In 2015, a concussion, out for 2 months. 2013, a left kidney removal, 4 to 8 months out of the sport. 2011, concussion, out 4 months. And equally in 2008, a left shoulder separation, out 2 months. So those types of injuries, particularly the concussion, are which are more and more prevalent nowadays, they will leave you really having to find ways in which to be motivated and at the best of your game. But McLaughlin is capable of that, but probably some of the decision more tactical to release some of the pressure from her by Johnson, taking her out in the second quarter and utilizing the younger arms and body of Erin Young, and just give a little bit of a different combination. Young just 20 years of age. She's a 4.5 as well. The crowd, they've been sensational. And I can say it in a sentence. Brazilians love sport, and probably two sentences. They love a good party. And this has been one big sporting party at the Paralympic Games, particularly in the wheelchair basketball event. Miller, she's almost bankable from there. And I prefaced it with almost. She just comes short on that one. She's been the most reliable shooter from field goals as yet for Germany. This one she rattles around and drops it down for a point. So the lead so far in the second quarter belonging to Canada, 6 points to 5. Young has that go off her body. They get a little bit fortunate here, do the Canadians. But then the decision has been rectified. It's going to be Germany who get the opportunity for the inbound. There was no doubt that Young had a touch of it. And she double touched it. And I think that maybe just deceived the referees for a moment. Into Monen, the fallen German player. And the rosy cheeks of their captain, as you can see, already in full flow. She's very much the leader, just makes great decisions. This is a shot that can't be executed. Gives the ball up when another player is in a better position, but she's got a great feel for the tempo of her team, does Marina Monen, and what's required. There's a foul though from behind, and that, as much as it is a foul, that's also required too. Be a physical presence, don't allow easy baskets for the Canadians, and make sure that whatever they do get, they're gonna have to work for it. And every time you're gonna go up for 2 points, you're gonna end up wrapped around in contortions as Ouellette was a moment ago. It does, of course, weigh on the mind, and it is a consideration. That is gorgeous. You see her really having to load that free throw up. She takes it behind her right shoulder and just drops that right elbow, and those are two of the most precise free throw bullets right into the chamber, and she fires a couple off, and they will rack up a 20-second point for Canada on the board. They're back within three. Some room, really, for Germany. A double team up against Monen into the high key area. They need to get a rebound here, Canada. It's an almighty bun fight. And it's gonna go to what is ultimately possession arrow. The indication of a 50-50 ball. Canada may be a little bit lucky there. I'm not sure they entirely had control of that ball. It was on the floor, and that's a little bit of a reach, particularly when it's laying flat there. Ouellette was gonna hitch there for a shot up in the face of Miller, but she'll hold. What's her options down low? To Harnock, it's rather searching that effort, and they will lose that possession, Canada. You could see that Ouellette was committed to that pass, and that takes away any real urgency to front up against her in the shot. Hindsight's 20-20, but she might have been better positioned to just to take the shot. Mohnen, the offload down low. Germany with just good, consistent decision-making. Keeping the spread and their nose in front of Canada. Canada are gonna have to have a turning point basket or a couple in a row, a little bit of a run, as they've been in the shadow of Germany so far in this matchup. Down low in the course of shooting. She'll go to the line, and this has been some great support offensively for what they've not been able to get from McLaughlin so far. Yan has come in, and she, 28 years of age, a 3.0. She'll go to the line. She's got 8, and this an opportunity to go to double digits from the free throw line. Harnock now out, and Hawtin is in. That won't go. So McLaughlin out on the floor again. Oulette, they are bookends across this lane. Yan to shoot. She'll get the second one. And that now makes it a even numerical value ahead for Germany. That one point ends up being decisive, where each possession can swing the lead, but Canada have not been able to really get any closer than this each time they do. It's Germany who put their focus in and just execute a better passing play. They seem to have too much room, Germany, in the offensive key area for Canada. Didn't see who let the three-point play, and that is encouraging. PATZWALD, the foul on it. As Oulette takes that, she knew that she was going to run out of angle. She had to take it, immediately puts it up. She had been bumped en route as she was receiving it. And this only really is effective and swinging as far as an impact to the scoreline as she hits this free throw. It can't leave points at the line, Canada. And they do again. Miller is gonna have to throw on the brakes, but she's always got a passing option to Lindholm. And a bigger target, this, the other 4.5 for Germany. Schunemann down to Miller. Miller with the over the top. And is this gonna be a change of possession or a foul? That looks to be worked out for Germany. As over right there, Oulette is down. And are they gonna help her up? She's boxed in at the feet of the German bench, and there they get her upright. But as you can see, Germany more focused on what they've gotta do right now. And Glinicky just casting his eye over the constant prompts coming from the bench. Schunemann to Zeyen. Shot clock, 10 seconds. That's up, and it's been turned over. And it looked as though it had crawled along their back and got away from again. Oulette is gonna take on this German team. She's gone through 4, she's drawn the foul. And she was slipping right through him like a knife through, well, let's say a hot knife through butter. She's starting to heat up. There's no doubt of that. And there's just a little bit of body surfing. Maybe even wheelchair surfing as she just slices through that German defense like Black Forest cake. And a couple more for Canada. And Miller, she's just bumped in. It's an offensive foul, so Canada just hold. That's Tamara Steeves that just parks it, throws it, and puts the parking brake on and allows the Germans to just run right into her. And what had been a slow starting quarter, they've picked up a little bit of momentum here now, the Canadians. And these two are in an almighty tug of war. McLaughlin hasn't even got going yet. 2 points really on the sidelines, even when she's been on court. She's been isolated. But Ouellette has come and shouldered the load and has brought this game back level. That last 2 points, putting Canada now back and resetting the decks. Ultimately, the game is just shortened. They started level. They're now level again with 4:12 remaining in the second quarter. Now Johnson, much more vehement in the coaching circle for the red and white. It's great insight to be able to hear what the coaches are saying. And whilst my German isn't quite what it used to be, you heard what was said on the Canadian bench about being one thought ahead of what the Germans were doing. And the Germans have been that for the entirety of the match, better than Canada. They have known what they want to do with the ball even before receiving it. And every time the option they are selecting has been available and has been open for what's been, in the most, an uncontested shot. The Canadians are going to be much better defensively. They're going to give Schoonman a look from here, and she will just massage the rim with the leather. Ouellette, she's looking like she's going to park up for a three. She'll hold. She'll come in closer for McLaughlin, and now they're starting to roll. Double trouble as McLaughlin's just been released from her shackles. And Canada, in doing so, cut through 30 points, and they take a 2-point margin. Well, this coming in to the end of the second quarter, the first half of play, this is very much the ball game. Both teams, as you know, are going to be right in the thick of this one. You don't see either of them relenting and really starting to take it to the other. This is going to be tight all the way through. But this is the first real spell after Germany have controlled proceedings for Canada to put their clutches into this match and lay claim to it. Now they've gone a little bit quiet, the Germans, with their shots. They've missed the last couple. And McLaughlin, who has had a sputtering start, all of a sudden is starting to feel the vibrations. And she's just going to hold, get it back to Ouellette. Ouellette, a couple times, she's hitching from that range. This one, though, will get away, and the strong possession from Germany. Double hands on it, safety first. And Schoonman has got the inward pass to Zeyen. But she's being pushed out. Hodson's got her back to her. That's enough, though, to force her from a shooting range that she's not comfortable with. And then McLaughlin with a defensive rebound. You sense that a three ball is coming from somewhere. It's going to most likely be Ouellette. And Ouellette, they're not going to call that a foul. And she felt that she was going into the teeth of that German defense and that she might as well just take a surge at the basket in hopes that she was going to get the call for her, the offensive, or rather the defensive foul, and giving her a chance. Look at this for Yan. Yan just shapes that into her own team's possession. She extended herself so much that she got herself into the spinning 360 here. And a little bit of the bunny hop at the end. Just too much force against the wheels. And she could maintain her balance in Klinicky right now. Boy, he looks like he's on the edge. As Germany is getting a little bit edgy about, they've been systematically been able to build that lead. They had a 6-point lead after the first quarter, but right now they are 17-9 down in the second. Total score has got Canada out in front by two. Yeah, and you saw her good sense of humor about the position she ended up in. She really has shown some great scoring prowess. They'll bat that around. Yan will pick it up. Back to McLaughlin. 4-5 German defenders. They've knocked it around, and Miller's got great hands, but she just can't recover that one. When you talk about Yan's productivity, she's a 4 point per game average, and she already now has 9. And we're not done the opening half, so that's just showing you she's over 100% above her normal levels of productivity, and she's picked up a slack for McLachlan. Otherwise, Canada would be in the trail in this one. McLachlan, the attempt to Ouellette. Ouellette is just stripped. And you see Schoonmann. Schoonmann's taking no prisoners. And that reaching in, bringing about her own irritation. And you can see that sometimes when the wheels, the smaller wheels, get caught in the spokes of the bigger wheels of the opponent. They do. They want to speed off. They want to use their strength and their power to accelerate, to perform. And they're often getting hindered, restrained. It's all part of it, but it's equally frustrating. Zeyen will launch one up. It's a little bit long and strong. McLachlan's just going to see that go out. Last touch by Germany. And this, at 3:41, I was suggesting that this last passage of play is going to be an indication as to who has really that mental control, the confidence that when push comes to shove, they're not going to break. They might bend, but they've got the resolve in which to make the most of the opportunities. Yan again, that receiving of the ball sets up that shot, but Ouellette just a little too forceful. She just takes that though, didn't she, Yan? It looked, the way she had to extend, as though she might lose her balance from that leaning over and leaning out. A shot that's rather a pass into the tall option. And Germany are starting to decrease noticeably in their field goal percentage. Their overall, Canada are shooting at 54%. And Germany, who were up in the 70s, are now down to 46. And that one will just get away. So both sides not as effective as they might like to be in this closing few minutes. But there is a window for Germany to score. They're deliberate about it. They want to use the remaining seconds. A little bit of a momentum shift. They're going to have to get it up quickly. McLachlan's having none of it. The tall maple tree will extend her arms. That's going to come pretty short, that one, but the idea, obviously a good one. And for Canada, who were down after the first quarter, they'll take the lead into halftime. It's Canada 31, Germany 29 in the women's wheelchair basketball. This is day 4 overall, and both of these teams are in their third match, right in the teeth of a real tussle. The field goal percentage, as you see for Canada, the average 52% between the twos and the 3-point shots. Free throws, Germany a little bit better. Defensive rebounds for Canada, they've been able to, for the most, tidy things up, but they've turned it over a little bit more as well, 7 times. And that's where we'll rest after the opening 20 minutes. And this has really got the chance of going both ways. Canada are 2-0 coming into it, so they've got a little bit of wind in their confidence and at their back. Germany working hard though, and they're gonna have to find a way to reconstruct the lead that they enjoyed after the opening quarter. Enjoy the halftime entertainment. We'll join you for the third quarter coming up in a moment. fans inside the Karaoke Arena 1 have kept entertained and ready for the commencement of the second half of play. It was Germany who took the opening quarter and looked to be poised to be just pushing on, but the Canadians found a different gear, and they have just slightly nosed their way in front by the two-point margin, as you see. It's now the third quarter coming up. This is the third match for both of these nations, and Canada 2-0 so far. Maybe some are suggesting they're performing above their station, but this is a very deep German team that's got a lot of different looks to it as well. And there's a slow start for the big center for Canada, number 5, McLaughlin, but she got rolling at the end of that second quarter. And some great work as well from Yan, the number 8 for Canada. It's 9, sorry, rather, Amanda Yan, and she has... She's got 9 points, Ouellet with 13, and they really leading the way. And that, again, a possession arrow. As it's a jump ball, 50-50. And Canada have it from the inbound. You heard it from the Canadian coaches talking about being one step ahead if they can. Both of these teams very cerebral, good thinking basketball brains. And they utilize their full complement of personnel. You have to, you can't just rely on a two-pronged attack. McLaughlin from the outside. That's the first shot. And it encircles the back of the rim and caroms out. So she's got 4 points so far, and that's a ways off what you might expect from her. Her average output has been at 17 for the entirety of a match, and that's across the couple that they've played against Great Britain and against Argentina. But up, and it is a score that's level this one. There's the captain. She's Miss Dependable for Germany, Marina Mohnen. And she's at 19 points. Her and Mareike Miller, the two, are out on the floor. They lead the way equally for Germany so far. Ouellet has elected not to shoot from three-point range. She's had one from there and just not feeling it today. So there's a couple times where you thought maybe a look was available, but it feels rather wasteful if you don't convert it, that you take that shot rather than getting a touch to some of your teammates, that if they're not able to score, at least they feel activated. And they're there, ready, more alert, more receptive to being relied upon as needed. And now a couple back-to-back baskets for Germany. And that is the opening score for First, the German player. And she's just a couple minutes, just starting in this third quarter. Ouellet will find that one in her pocket. She pulls out a trick, and it's 2 points to level this one. It's threes all across the board right now, both sides. Nice touch there, and they do work it in. The quick passing play, and Zeyen getting the benefit of that one touch. It's just a volley on, isn't it, from the German captain. McLaughlin has had to work for her chances. There's been nothing easy about it yet for her. As she takes this one, doesn't let it go forward. That's already started the clock as soon as she touches it. So sometimes you'll see them just allow it to bounce a little bit, and that might just give them more time offensively with the ball, but they've stripped it. Germany have started the better. They're 6 points to two already in this third quarter. First being attended to by Lalonde, and too wide open is Mohnen right there. You're not seeing a McLaughlin get that look, or equally Ouellet getting that unattended, rolling off of a pick and being in such a great position. So that's something that maybe the Canadians need to consider. Germany have found a technique in which to force McLaughlin to have to shoot from those types of positions. She's been boxed in, She has no forward momentum. It's not as if she's rolling towards the basket in a shooting motion, taking her natural momentum. She's stationary, and then has to generate her own power, and then generally with a couple hands up in her face. And Germany, as they did in the opening quarter, have come out in the second half, and they are setting the standard by which this match will be played. 8-2, and Canada are looking devoid of a response. So you see the unique haircut there from Cindy Ouellette. Those are actually the seams of a basketball. She's got the headband though across there. So you're not really seeing it in the full reflection of what the design actually is, but it's gonna be an inbound. LALONDE back to Ouellette. McLaughlin stripped of it. And that's what Miller, she's proven the most active defensive player, has Miller. Well, look at her. She's got steals, she's got two steals, couple assists. She's turned it over once. But between her and Monin, they both will get their hands in. They've got a couple steals each, and the Canadians have been exploited a few times already with that. Just one for McLaughlin and one for Ouellette. So whilst it might seem like a small detail, it contributes to the difference of the 4 points. Now it's six as Germany continue to stroke it. And Monin, she's so meticulous and effective. Just really count on her as the mother of this side for Germany. Leading, supporting, protecting, and ultimately making those great decisions consistently for Germany. That's a shot though back. Keeps this within check. And it's these turning point passages in play. It is really just Germany just systematically just trying to establish, reestablish that lead and keep Canada in their wake. And now it's a half dozen. And that is Argentina, the women's wheelchair basketball team, just watching from the sidelines. McLaughlin underneath to LALONDE. Is that gonna go? I think the foul comes in prior to the shot. And you see McLaughlin having a query to the referee about it. And it's a turnover. Sure whether or not it was just that she was 3 seconds in the key, and we'll just confirm. It is 3 second violation. That's exactly what the call is. In the key, and that was a turnover assessed against McLaughlin. So a steal right back though, and the Canadians need it. They need something to build from. They've had a very meek third quarter. They're being tripled up, 12-4 at the moment. And this, it needs to be a quick response. LALONDE though, however, is gonna need a little engine in her wheelchair in order to accelerate her hopes of recovering that ball. It's gonna, in fact, go for Germany with the inbound. And now Yan, she gets herself suited and booted, ready to return to action. You see the strapping on her left shoulder. She really has shouldered the load in the absence of what McLaughlin normally can provide offensively. It has been Germany's game plan is to keep her outside, and Mareike Miller having a great day right now. She is powering through this matchup. And I can't think of a time. She's got 15 points, 75% from the free throws, but also 67 from 2-point range. But I can't think of a time where I thought that Miller made a direct mistake. She has been smart, both her and Monin, just playing the game at a very high level. They're looking to feed it to Monin, if she can they find the advance here? Hutson has to have a look. She will turn and get to this one. And Canada have turned it over. This could be a little bit of a swing. And that's Houghton that was so attentive to Monin that she didn't realize the ball was there that she could have played into. But nonetheless, Canada do come up with it. Ouellette is putting herself under a lot of pressure, having to make a shot from there. And she will. He finds that one from what looked to be nowhere. And she just plucks herself an ace and puts that one up for 19 points. And those are the types of shots that can win you a ball game. When it looked against the odds that she was going to be successful, she pulls one out of the holster in the OK Corral and fires one bullseye. Miller with a little hitch and a roll. Yan takes it. The feed now to the overlap. And this is Ouellet. And a response late here in his third quarter. If they hit another shot, Canada will have started to find a roll here. That is a roll they did not get the favor from, though. Just allowing too much time, it seems, in this middle court area for Germany to assess how they want to attack. And then equally enough room to just move into lanes. Miller moves the ball so quickly that that makes up for any sort of misgiving sometime. It just advances it and allows players to be in position with the ball longer in order to make a better decision with it. This is Ouellet, who gets the rocket pass from McLaughlin. But immediately she's got Miller on her like her shadow. And that will leave her fingertips and fall from the court. And you see her as she punches her open palm with her knuckle sandwich. She's not happy about it. Now Miller and Monin, a 1-2 punch. They've been a little bit more consistent and reliable. And that's what you're seeing reflected in the scoreline overall right now. That's the over the top and a smothering blanket of Maple Leafs. Right over this German attack. And it's still going to be the German inbound. You get a sense though that McLaughlin is working through the difficulties of an under firing performance. And she may just, as a battle tested warrior, have enough at the right time if Canada can keep this tight and maybe be able to just put in a workhorse performance. And that's the sign of a good player. When you're not at your best, to still be effective when it counts. Yan will shoot and she scores. So she has picked up that slack and that now back within two inside the closing minute of his third quarter. And this cloud, or this crowd rather, or maybe the cloud, around the Canadian offense that has been a little bit in fits and starts, starting to be lifted again as we close in. But there you'll see it again. Monin, who just knows how to be in and around the right places at the right times, getting the most from her shots. So effective. And she just doesn't overcook it. She's 53%, doesn't try to be the hero. Just tries to play her game. She stays within herself, and that really can't be underestimated as to how important a quality that is for a leader on your team. Just stays the course. And being constructive, being diligent, and equally performing in the moments that count most. Lalonde, this is Ouellet, quickly, and she's hit it. So the first shot, and that takes her total on the day up to 20. And she would have loved that. They would have loved the offensive rebound, the Canadians. They will not get it. Can they control this German approach? This is gonna have to be an almighty heave. They're gonna get it up. Miller will fire it. It's off the back glass. As you see the red light illuminating around the rectangle glass unit up. And this now, again, it is getting interesting. That was an overwhelming start from Germany, but then the Canadians take a chunk out of it. It's 16-11 in that third quarter, and it's 45-42 overall for Germany at three-quarter time. The field goal percentages, flip a coin. Defensive rebounds, flip a coin. They're really, other than the turnovers, the Canadians have turned it over more. You see that stat. That's probably the biggest swaying impact to the little trends in the game that are indicating that maybe the tidier and more efficient today could be the Germans. A battle between second and third place in Group A right now. Whoever is victorious in this one will take a higher position. It all depends on the overall games played. They play four matches in the preliminary round in this women's tournament. The top four teams of each group of five will go through directly to that quarterfinal round. The other two teams, they haven't got a chance. This is a shot, though. They go into the classification for ninth and tenth position. So it's all open once you get to that quarterfinal round. You could go deep in this tournament and put yourself in medal contention. So these games and who you're going to play in that opening quarterfinal, they are massive. And this is what this battle is. It's all about positioning. And that opening shot, well taken by Germany. And now a little bit of room in the scoreline opens up for the Germans to increase it to seven with this possession. First, a hard-working player. ZEYEN the same. Every single player is, but they more industrious, and they've just lost track of time there. And the shot clock gets away from them. There isn't a whole lot. You've got 8 seconds in which to get it over, but it's overall 24 seconds to go from one end to the other and take your shot. And right now, you're seeing the Canadians employing the same tactics that the Germans have been utilizing to great effect all game. They're just trying to get Mohnen in a position where she's got to fight to get away. She can't just track this option. McLaughlin, Ouellette comes up, tries to draw a couple of defenders past Yan. If Yan can come up with a shot here and make it count, it's McLaughlin that is so busy working. Ouellette's wide open. She's got to take that shot. She'll get another one. She goes up for two. And that's just a smart play by Ouellette. She was no way in a good position to take that shot, but she knew that Miller had committed to the defense, the hand up. So she throws it up right through that extended arm, and she goes to the line here for a couple, and she has to convert them, as Canada have been, again, a little bit slow out of the gates to start this fourth quarter. And she won't with the first. And when I say half, it's just, it's about confidence. And Canada had brought it level. They were in the lead, but in majority, they have trailed in this match so far. And that will reflect the story in the majority that Germany had just been a little more consistent. Picked up by Miller. She cuffs it and then wraps it around to her forehand side, but they assess a foul against Canada in the act of shooting.
Thank you.
miss those free throws that in the end of this match, they will, in fact, they'll be determining. Look at this sold out crowd, isn't it? Incredible, 12,000 in here. So Miller, 5 from 6, 83%. Overall, they're shooting 71% from the line. And the Canadians are shooting 54%. There's a discrepancy that could be telling. It's a 6-point spread now. So a couple games per session is on the docket. In this day for this crowd capacity, it has been a really family fun event. The Paralympic Games in general, but particularly the wheelchair basketball, great size arenas. The other one, the Rio Olympic Arena, over 16,000 people capacity, but this one is a little bit more intimate and it just has had the sense of a party in it. And the families have loved it. The youngsters that are here, they've utilized the whole stretch of the concourse for strollers. It just feels like a great place, particularly if it's a day off. I think a number of Brazilians, even if it isn't, are taking it, making sure to rejoice and celebrate what has been an outstanding hosting job from them as a nation in both the Olympics and now the Paralympic Games. And it's been a celebration of their own competence, and equally they've been pioneers, haven't they? The first ever in the South American continent. And they are coming through with shining colors. As an overall hosting committee, but they will give this up now, will the Germans. And it's just gone through a little bit of a slow passage right now, as this lead has been there. Both teams just plodding along on the score. Haven't had a lot of open play. This is probably going to start to shape out like some chess, where every move is being made with a counter move in mind. And they both just try to outthink one another. Yan with a shot, that's just golden. She really has been. And there you see it. She's tripled her average output. And she's up with 13 points now, rocking it at 75% from the field goal range, 6 from 8. And that's just under 20 minutes overall that she's played. And she is a big reason why this game is still in the balance. So precise and so intimidating is that level of excellence coming from the German captain. Marina MOHNEN now with 18. She's shooting at 56%. It seems though that every time she needs to come up with a shot, her side is counting on her. She seems to hit it. This one is a loose ball, easily rebounded by the aforementioned MOHNEN. And look at her work. Just calmly in the course of what she knows how to do best. It's Miller who's come in from that left side with the right hand, and the angle always difficult to overcome. She's in a heap. This has been OUELLET, who's just powered her way forward, and she just catches it in. She takes that right on the German Autobahn, and it's a trans-Canadian point. It's a couple of them. It's now within 4. And a foul prior. Are they going to count the shot? And it really was quick work from Miller. They will. She gets that, and as soon as she receives it, she's already in the process of going up. So she'll get the bucket and a bonus opportunity. And this now 6 points ahead with a chance to go 7. This is where the Canadians have really got to find what is going to be and where are they going to hang their hat to find and make up these points. because there hasn't seemed to be any easy fast break points. Germany are back in position. If they set up in their half-court offense, they have matched up well against the Canadians. And it really has put a lot of pressure on their shooting game to have to be perfect. And when the pressure comes from mid to long range, stuff like this happens. You strip it right out of Ouellette. And Monin just too powerful, too big, and too ready to make the right move. The movement of the ball, quick. The scoring, precise. Again, Germany have just put on a master class in these last few minutes and showing the Canadians just how potent they are. So that'll bring about a timeout, and both teams will collect their thoughts with 5:16 remaining and what looks to be the match. They would go to extra time if they were required, but right now it's an 8-point spread, and that's as much as there has been a lead. So you hear the comments there from Bill Johnson, the coach. He's talking, these cheap fouls are not gonna help us. You make contact with a player before the ball arrives. Once the ball arrives, just keep your hand up and do not touch the opposing player, because we are opening up the opportunities continually for them to exploit us. So I can assure you, any of these empty seats is people just going out to get a beer, or they've gone to use the facilities, because at any one time on the concourse level, it's like a caramba out there. There just is a great energy. This particular facility on the concourse level outside is actually outside, it's external. It's got a wrapping around of it, but there really is great views and sight lines, and you can, through open air, see what's going on through the rest of the Olympic Park. So it really does have a real community feel about it, that you could be in this facility, but then also looking across the park, and there's no glass to prevent you from maybe even chatting to somebody, looking out, and then over as to what's going on down below. So a real well-constructed feeling within this building of just community. It'll be Ouellette who will take the feed and the couple points just ahead of the end of that possession. 2 seconds, we're still on the shot clock. It's back within, and it's LaLonde rather. And there you see the celebration. So LaLonde and Ouellette sometimes with their hair tied up as it is, and the dark-haired players, just very similar statures. And that, unusually, it does not fall, but they'll go to the line. They just have established that position down low, and a couple big targets. That's difficult to match up against, and you're seeing Miller and also Monin, they can so well move the ball and set. Oh, that really is, that's a suggestion there, right there. When the ball has bubbled around the rim to that degree and found a way to fall, it could be your day. This one is strong. It will not be a point, though, for Germany. And Ouellette is going to have to go to the book of trickery. Or just exceptional shooting. There was a little bit of the trickery from LaLonde. She tried to just spin that one against the grain, back over her head, and it will not go. But this is becoming an urgent time for Canada. What they've been doing so far has not quite been sufficient. They cannot to give up a defensive rebound. They reach in the foul, and they've been a little bit at the wrong times, absent in their thinking and in their intention, the Canadians. Germany have just been better at following up on their second chances, and every moment that they've had to be called upon, and even those they've generated for themselves, they are deserving of this 8-point lead right now. Mm-hmm. That one won't go. And remember, Canada, if this one doesn't fall either, they've got to be in a position to take this rebound. It will go. So it's 9. That's MOHNEN extending herself defensively and then just loses her balance. And they're going to suggest that OUELLET was in the course of shooting there. So the free throws from Canada right now, overall 54%, and that's not good enough. They've been 7-13, so they've left 6 points at the free throw line. 6 would come in awfully handy right now. And Johnson looks on. He's been a little bit frustrated, you might say, by the way this has played out. And he's talking about 2 shots here. He said, why is this becoming even a debate? And they're suggesting that she wasn't in the course of shooting, and it's going to be an inbound for Canada. And Johnson in a debate over there with the referee. She tunes him out. And maybe that's a moment that again is reflective of how Germany have done the good work in the times they've made hay when the sun was shining. And over this 4th quarter and the 3rd as well, they've had 29 points to 18 in this 2nd half. And that's where this scoreline sits right now. That's the 11-point spread. It's all been constructed in these latter 2 periods. McLaughlin, she hits one. And that just looked to be rather a plucky shot. She pulled it out and just threw it up. It's for 2. They're through the half-century mark now, the 51, and it's back within single digits. And right now, to take a line out of the movie Spinal Tap, the Canadians are going to have to be 1 louder. They're going to have to go to 11. They were 11 points out. It's now 9. But they're going to have to amp this thing up right beyond its limits and maximize everything they've got out on the floor right now to cut into this German side, because Germany have just been the more diligent and the more efficient of the 2 sides across the 4 quarters so far, particularly in the 2nd half. They gave up that lead that they established early, and they went in and they reset the decks at halftime. It's been a dominant performance, and the passing play there, that one will fall out, but they get the rebound. And that's the smaller player for Germany in there, picking that up. That's Breuer. And it's gonna be MOHNEN who takes another shot. If you keep getting 2 attempts at it every time, and they're good looks on the offensive rebound, well, of course you're gonna have success, particularly when they shoot as well as they do. And Canada will have only themselves to reflect upon. They've just not been in those positions. And you wonder whether or not some of the injuries and the illnesses to McLaughlin are starting to be reflected in this output. You never want to have any excuses, but when you went down the injury report of McLaughlin, already out 4 months this year, that's going to have a tremendous impact over the course of the entire 12 months' performance. And this is the peak of their athletic season. And all the travel and all of the being away for an extended period of time, there's only so much in the tank, isn't there? And that one will go wide, and it will miss. And that's Yan with the attempt, so she's had 13. McLaughlin with 6, 23 from Ouellette. They are the trio that offensively have contributed the most to the Canadian effort today. But another offensive rebound for Germany. Up again, a second effort, and it's in. And that is clear as day as to where the Canadians have opened up the door for Germany. As Ouellette is going to take this ball, and from this distance, going to start launching threes. But at 13 points, the differential, Jan takes that feed in, and she equally attracts the immediate attention of this German defense. And stripped. They've done that so many times today, Germany. I mean, look at their steal rate. And if we tally them up, Mohnen with 3, Schunemann with 1, 2 for Miller. And Breuer, she gets a foul there, but that was pretty much a steal as well. And that will not go. Both shots will just slip from the rim. And Miller, uncontested, the full length of the floor. She with another couple for Germany. It'll take her now to 22. And the timeout is utilized here by Canada. And although it looks as though at this point, 15 points back, the results may have just been beyond their grasp. These are great teaching moments at the end of a match to make sure you have your side's undivided attention out here in amongst these 12,000 people watching and the thousands of millions around the world, making sure that you are entirely focused, you're positive, and you're keeping together. You never break. You might bend, but you don't break. You take the hard lessons along the way, compartmentalize them, and remember to put it all within the big picture at the end of your day's work.
Come here, let's go, come, come.
Canada now with control. It's McLaughlin. We're into the final straight of this match. Shield from three-point range. That just goes off the face of the rim, and Ouellette will come up with the rebound, the ricochet here. Can she go into a position to convert it? They are having a number of attacks at it, Canada. This for McLaughlin. This one has been 4 attempts, and none of them successful. So doing the best that they can, but a little bit of fatigue coming in. It's been a very focused German side. And this lady here, she sets the pace at the highest level, does Mareike Miller. So does the captain, who just is backing away, receives that in motion. Look at these two. They're yin and yang. Perfectly synchronized, the offload from one to the other. Mohnen with a shot, this one off the rim. And for Ouellette, she's inside the last half minute. And Miller will just make sure she goes a country mile to try to get around to that ball. And she sends her into the rhubarb right there in front of the Canadian bench. So they'll look for a set play with 22.6. Utilize this as really ultimately one possession. And in live play, practice and execute a play that may be needed later in this tournament and work on it right here and now. He may have just woken up on the wrong side of the bed. They love it, don't they? Party time. Carnival season. Still a few months away. Not right. Remember, this is the winter months, from June through to September in Rio de Janeiro. And you just really can't tell that entirely by the weather, more by the wind. Gives you an indication that this is not optimum season. They would be 40 degrees Celsius at times at the peak of their summer. And that in the Northern Hemisphere, generally the winter months. Look at the three ball from McLaughlin. And she puts up a triple play and pops it. And so this now within 12, it's all but been determined. It's just how the score line will sit at the end. And this is also a part to play. This is about how the score will be reflected in determining some of the criteria. It'll be the direct results against each other, but there may be the accumulation of points for and against that could be a factor. So the Brazilians, their main language, Portuguese. That's what you'll have heard the fans responding to in the background. This now, the final ticks of the clock. And it seems almost like it has been an extended period these last couple of minutes. It's now going to the line for shots as a result of the fouls already committed by the Canadians. They commit another one, and Zeyen will perch her chair right at this foul line. And she, with enough momentum, finds it over the front of the rim. And back to back points, 14 clear. Yen off to McLaughlin. McLaughlin gives it to Ouellette. And the big launch of a shot, it just grazes the front of the rim. But Germany feeling good about things now. They're 2-1. And it's a full-time result. Germany 68, Canada 54.